In this video, we're going to take a look at a specific type of a materialization known as ephemeral. As a quick overview, materializations are strategies for persisting DBT models in a warehouse. You can think of it as it's how your models are going to deploy. We've talked about how you can configure them in a separate video. And as I mentioned in this one, we're going to look at ephemeral. So let's start to unpack that a little bit. I think ephemeral is one of the more interesting types of materializations because they're not directly built in the database. They're effectively just a common table expression. They're going to take the code that you write within your model, and whenever you reference it, it's going to be used as a CTE in that other model. Before we actually get into reviewing these pros and cons, let's go through an example first, and then we'll come back to this and it'll make a little more sense. So here we are back in our project, and what we're going to do is within one of our models, let's just say this example team, this is one we've used quite a bit in our examples. We are going to add the config block here and set materialized equal to ephemeral. And let's see what happens first off if we were to just try to run this model. What would happen? DBT run. Now remember, ephemeral is not going to persist. It's just a CTE. So let's see what happens if we try to run this guy. It compiled, it runs, but nothing was deployed. And that's because it's just a CTE and we didn't reference it anywhere. But what I do know is this example teams is used in another model, example team details, here as the first CTE. Remember, this is going to compile as a CTE. So now where we see this ref, instead of this being the fully qualified name of a database, schema, and table, it's going to select all from the CTE that we generate. Let's see what this looks like. Let's now try to run this example team details model. DBT run, and we would expect this model to run, but what will be interesting is when we go into how it's compiled. Okay, so this was run. Let's go into our target, run, and example team details, and take a look at what we got here. So here we can see this now looks a little different than what we're used to. We can see DBT CTE. This is what's going to happen when you use the ephemeral model. It's replacing it with this. We're looking at these side by side, and let's clean this part up a little bit so we can get a better view. If we look at this here, let's actually bring this one up now too. Everything from here to here is pulled from this example underscore teams. This is our ephemeral model is being placed within this CTE here. So again, it's literally copying and pasting everything from right here, right into here. And now what we can see, if we go back to team details over here, select all from that ref, teams is now select all from this. It compiled it within a CTE by itself, and now we're selecting it in another CTE. It's kind of like Inception, and it can get a little confusing sometimes, but the idea here is now this model is not deployed as its own materialized table or view in Snowflake. It's only going to be visible when you run it. So now let's go back to the documentation and review some of those pros, cons, now that we've seen this in action a little bit. Okay, let's review again here. So first off, pros. You can still write reusable logic, that's true. We were able to put those in a separate model and then reference it. And they can help you keep your data warehouse clean by reducing clutter. And that's because it's not going to actually deploy. As we saw, it's just going to compile it as another CTE within a CTE, depending on how you use it. And what they're saying here is, alternatively, you could just still deploy your models, but use custom schemas and put them in different places. That's an option too. And if you're curious about custom schemas, there is another video that touches on that. You can learn a little bit more about how that works. What are some cons? You cannot select directly from this model. Again, that's because it's built as a CTE. It doesn't exist anywhere other than in the DBT project when it compiles. Overuse of ephemeral can also make queries harder to debug. And this is true now that we saw what that compiled version looks like. You can imagine if you have a lot of those, that can get a little tricky to figure out what's happening where and debug that. So some general advice, use ephemeral for lightweight transformations that are early on in your DAG. Only use for one or two downstream models and for models that do not need to be queried directly. I think a lot of this makes more sense now that we've seen it. That's why I wanted to go over it first and show you what it looks like. So I think there's a lot of ways you could use this and you can be creative, but now hopefully you have a baseline understanding of how this type of materialization works and you can figure out in your project where you might want to use this. Thanks for watching.